Voices against corruption. Let the people speak.
Hello and welcome to Primus Public Feedback Series on Corruption, called Voices Against Corruption. And we ask, do you think corruption is responsible for the massive unemployment in Nigeria?
The foundation of unemployment in Nigeria is corruption. That is the basic and the foundation of all the evil you are seeing here.
When you could talk about job racketing, the elites are more involved, especially those who have the opportunity to be in the leadership of this country. They take their time. All the juicy employments are being given to their people, their relatives, their sons and daughters. But the security jobs are being left for the masses. Have we ever seen where an advert is placed on NNPC, CBN job? But every time they are advertising. But when, once there is police recruitment, you see it all over the website. Once there is road safety and civil defense, you see it all over the website. Everybody will have to apply because those jobs are made for the poor.
I am from the region that you need to know somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody before you get a job. You will go to school, you will read, you come out with a good result. You come out with a very good result. 4.20 in my school is 2.1. I wrote 4.20. I am still on the street. They say, go and serve. I finished my service. My brother, I am still on the street. They know you are able. They know you are capable to work. But they will not give you work.
You can imagine somebody sitting in the office, enrolled all the family members in the list, and they are paying them on a monthly basis. They call them ghost workers. Is that, wouldn't that cause unemployment? That alone will cause massive unemployment because those that are qualified will not have access to those job employment. Those that are not qualified are there at home enjoying the benefits that are not supposed to be for them. So as we speak, corruption is as good as the reason why we are like this in our country.
When there's a lot of corruption, then you're not making, there's no revenue generation. When there's no revenue generation, there's no employment. You're not empowering the masses.
Yes, it does affect unemployment in Nigeria. Reason being that we know that generally the system in Nigeria is corrupt. And I'm saying that because there has been instances. You find out that somebody who goes to school, spend like 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, comes out, goes out to look for a job. You know, it's very hard for the person to get a job, even with your certificate. I was speaking to my younger brother the other day, and he says he doesn't want to complete university anymore because it feels like there is no need. And this is because our government have put a question mark. Young people go to school now, and they have this mentality that they are wasting their time because, after all, when they come out, there is no job.
Corruption has been one of those bedrock that have killed the talent, the vision, the mission of every young Nigerian. When I was younger, they said, children, they were used to tell us that we are the leaders of tomorrow. When is our own leadership turn comes? Is it when we are all gone? When we are still having aging fathers, aging mother occupying offices that we, you and I, are supposed to occupy? We were given all the necessary training back in our university days to occupy offices. When are they ready to leave that chance for us? When are we going to be employed? When are our own children going to enjoy the office they have been enjoying those days?
It's very glaring that Nigeria has the highest rate of unemployment rate in the world. Like recently, the president was comparing Nigeria with a very developed country like Saudi Arabia. This is a country where the minimum wage is not less than 310,000 in Naira. And here in Nigeria, 30,000.
Before you can get a job in this nation, you have to know someone that knows someone before you can be given a job. Not just a well-paid job. It might be a job of 30K. You might even be more qualified than the people the slot are actually reserved for. But because you don't know someone, you don't know people at the top, they will not give you the job unless you know someone.
In Nigeria today, it's very difficult for a graduate to see a work now. Because I have someone also who have graduated for many years now. He doesn't have anything to do. This on the corruption that is going on in Nigeria.
Corruption of a thing has much of big effect on unemployed in Nigeria, because if you go to an office and you know that you're qualified to get a job, but due to that someone sitting down there has a slot maybe for his relationship or his son or daughter, so you end up not getting the job. That's part of corruption.
Those who are saddled with the responsibility of creating jobs are oftentimes sidelining those who are actually qualified for this job. And we all know that especially in government employment, they are always hired and they are always sold out. People pay for this. If that's not corruption, I don't know what it is.
With the statistics available, we have a population of over 200 million people. Government cannot employ 200 million people from the way I look at it. Now, I understand that young people are up to 109 million. And I don't understand how government is going to do that. But there are ways government has created or is trying to create things that could trickle down on the younger ones we get. Now, if you have high grades, you should put what you've studied into manifestation. You'll be a wealth creator.
Primark's public feedback on corruption in Nigeria is produced with support from MacArthur Foundation.